Hello there. I thought I would, at long last, take everyone on a little tour of my garden that I have more or less single-handedly created in my backyard. First, though, I want to take you to this corner of the yard to give you an idea of what the yard looked like before I started. The entire yard was like this, like a total dump. Just filled with debris and stuff that people had just thrown wherever for decades. Also, California had been in a drought at that point for about 10 years, 8 years or something. So this kind of stuff, this is actually neat, but no, it was just strewn. Look, here's an old bathtub, which this stuff is still here, by the way. So, however, the yard is big, and here is a view, I don't even know if I can get it all in, of some of the crazy magic I have worked. The Lord has worked, I should say.
I just came out with a shovel. Anyway, so look, it has little pea gravel.
I've become acquainted with pea gravel. These are river rocks. This is Pasadena, California, so there's all kinds of rocks. And some of these I collected with my bare hands from the yard. Like there was a kind of a dump that I found that was, I think people had just dug a hole or piled them up or something. So I dug a lot of these out with my bare hands, but then a lot of them,
there's various sizes, have come over the last year and a half, 2 years from my travels.
So I'm just gonna start at this little corner. Okay, so these are some succulents. Most all of these, this is called a pencil plant, I think, a fire plant or something. Most all of these are grown from cuttings. This is a dwarf Meyer lemon,
for which I was reimbursed from the city of Pasadena,
from their little reimbursement tree program. But these are all succulents. Look at that gorgeous thing. Most all grown from little teeny cuttings from people's yards. This was given to me, this cactus given to me by my new friend Ellen Hoffs, who has a beautiful garden. Succulent. Okay, most of these, or a lot of them, are native plants, California natives, not all of them, but. And the purpose of that is to rebuild the environment, quote unquote, and sort of attract native birds and insects and stuff. So this is called a Fremontia, aka the flannel bush. It has these beautiful gold blooms. It has bloomed for the first time this year. You cannot water it in the summer at all, or apparently it instantly dies, but it's very beautiful. And the flannel, the word flannel comes from if you, the leaves are super, they have little things on them that I guess are quite itchy actually. These are two cactus that someone just weirdly gave me out of the blue. So I planted them. They were full grown already. This is called, there's all kinds of mallow. This is a mallow, and there are various kinds. There's apricot mallow. This is called a lunar of some kind. I think moon, white, luna. It's got white blooms, native plant. Look, it's just grown huge. This is a sage. I'm blanking on the name. One of these is a Figueroa sage. I have a bunch of sages, but that's one of them. This is another one. This too is a sage. This is a white sage. These get huge. This is called a coffee berry bush, which has not grown a whole lot in a year and a half. Native plant, but it's looking pretty good. It's got little incipient blooms. These were already here. These are sort of yuccas of some kind. These are aloes that I planted. This is called a BOP. I see the shadows in the way. BOP, don't ask me what it stands for, but initials. BOP penstemon. I have a bunch of penstemon. So small, already in bloom. This is some kind of monkey flower. There's lots of different kinds of monkey flower. That's a scarlet monkey flower. This is a grevillea, beautiful Australian plant. I think I got a, maybe I got a 15 gallon. It was pretty good size, but it's at least six times bigger than it was. Here's an agave you see a lot around LA. These get huge. Poppies. Native California poppies. This is our native California flower, actually grown from seed. The seed was just strewn about. Look, it's all over the garden. Beautiful. This is a ceanothus. Blooms blue. I don't know if you can see. Actually, will get quite big. It's already probably almost 6 feet tall. 4 or 5 feet wide, so that's cool. Another succulent. This is a black sage. This is a little teeny, I just bought it. It's called a pink fairy duster. If you can even see it, but when it grows, it'll get to be a good sized bush, and it has these really cool, sort of dark pink, almost like a little. A duster, hence the name, like a feather duster, pink. This is hummingbird sage. Again, I'm quite proud of, as it has finally grown. And there's its sister over here. And then this is a night blooming cereus. Look at this. This was from a cutting that a friend gave me in Windsor, Vermont. She had a huge plant indoor, clearly, for Vermont. She gave me a cutting that I saved on a Dunkin' Donuts plastic tumbler on a windowsill in New York City for a week, and then brought home with me on the